Hello everyone, it's D.VE here, and this is part 5 of the Explorative Sky playthrough. This is Spoink. He just gives you a ton of items. I can't remember what they are. I think it's orange berry and stuff like that. You have to answer a question, I think. He's trying to get. I just sped this part up because it's a fairly long part, and it's, you know, it's just, yeah, it's alright, it's great. But even so, it's alright. Not great though. But alright, let's get this part underway. So anyway, Chimeco's here. It's like tea time. So anyway, we're just eating away and Wigglytuff's just spinning around its apple. But okay, so it's night time again. And it's like they talk about the day and stuff like that, rescuing Spoink's pal, and we're on to chapter 3 now. It's like, rise and shine, it's morning. So anyway, we do that. So I'm saving the adventure quickly before we continue, and then now we're off. And smiles go for miles, you don't have to sit through all that today. And Chatot's like, wait, you two, follow me. So, right, follow Chatot now to the top. It's like, this, what is this board? And it's this. And it's like, I thought it was the other board over there for job. This is the outlaw, but, one, he says. So, switching to dual screen now, you can see the top as well as that at the bottom. He's like, what's happened? Where's he gone? And then Chatot will now explain what's happening. It's like, it's rather simple, because it's like, swaps over of outlaw data. So anyway, back to one screen now, because there's nothing interesting on the top now. Just so you could see that, just for curiosity if people are asking. And it's like, Bidoof's up here, and it's like, yay, it's Bidoof. So Chatot's gone, and now we're on to Bidoof. So Bidoof is crying, he's like, I'm so happy. And now he's back to normal. He's like, follow me. So anyway, Bidoof will take you downstairs and show you what's what. This is like, this is Krogon swap area. You can swap items in here. At the minute he's fixing his cauldron or something, so you can't do it just yet. That's your sleeping bit when you save the game. That's the guildmaster's office. If Chatot outside. So if you go up here, it's got, so it comes out, this is the first time you've been properly out of the guild into the village, even though you're not allowed to just run off at the minute and play. This is the path to the dungeons, where you just run to the side and it goes select the dungeon. Down there is towards the beach, and you go to the beach cave through there, or the other way. That's the Duskull Bank just there. So anyway, he'll just explain. This is the Duskull Bank, where you can store all your money, just if you go before expeditions. This is the XI Link shop where you link moves together, but isn't here. Into the next zone, it is the Kecleon Brothers shop, and you can buy items and TMs. That's Kangaskhan's storage facility. So anyway, he goes, so they speak about it a bit more, and he goes, so it's down here, it's, so Bidoof walks off. So anyway, let's have a quick explore. There's nothing up there, there's usually a character or so standing there. There's the Chansey Egg Shop just there. This is the Marowak's training dojo, and he's like, Marowak is training, or is it collapsed or something, and he's fixing it. I can't really remember. But this is the Chansey's Egg Shop, where if you get an egg from a mission as a reward, you can do that. But I'm just sprinting off now. Okay, to proceed, head to the Kecleon Brothers Shop. That's Zatu's appraisal down there, which you can look at, where you can look at the boxes and get an item from there. Costs quite a bit though, it depends if you get a good item. Can you remember where that was? That's where we camped out at the end of the last game. Explorer's Time and Darkness. Okay, back here. To proceed, talk to the Kecleon Brothers. and you can have a look at their merchandise. But before you've done, I'm not going to buy anything because I don't have any more room in my bag because I've only got 16 items at this stage in the game. Which is kind of a letdown because I actually like more items in your bag because it's more useful going through the longer dungeons, but that'll be upgraded in time. Just make sure we get enough. But this is like the Marill and the Djurel. And they're like, oh, can we have an apple for our mum, Azumarill, who's ill? Something like that. And then they come back and they go, Mr. Kecleon, you've given me an extra apple. And they're like, that apple's for you. And so Azumarill's really happy. And she trips over and the apple goes rolling. So we pick it up and we give it back to her. Because that's how nice we are. And then we kind of get this weird thing starting up where the screen starts flashing. It's like, what's happening to me? But anyway, it does matter because the key point, and you get that thing shoot across the screen, whatever it was, and then goes, what's happened? And then now we've just got to sit through minutes of our partner asking if we're alright. Just joking. It's only about 30 seconds long. But then Azumarill runs off after Marill. Marill's like, oh, there you are. So I'm just coming after you. So anyway, after we've done that, we can, Slappy, the Piplup is like, yeah, okay. You're right, Deepon VE. And I'm like, yeah, because I'm just a cool chimcha. But anyway. So it goes, we're inside, what's happening? So we're like, meh. So anyway, let's head back to the guild. So you run through here and enter another cutscene. Drowsy and an Azumarill and the Marill. So it's the two characters who saw from earlier. We've seen this one, and it's like, I lost my water float, and this Mr. Drowsy is going to look for it, or something like that, or Mr. Drowsy is looking after it. Drowsy's like, oh, no problem, and he's acting like real cool. And he's like, oh, pardon me. And he's getting in, oh god, not another flash. It's all we need. So anyway, he goes like, oh, so hurt. Anyway, that just flies across the screen, and it's like, what's happening? It's Drowsy's a bully. Azumarill. There it is. It took a while coming. But, so it's like, okay then, let's head back to guild. Stuff them. So anyway, let's run. It's like, what's happening? Let's get back to the guild. It's like, so unfair. But oh well, come on, let's just go. Oh, come on. Don't go away. They just talk about it and it's like, oh, I'm happy now, let's go back to the guild. It's like, oh, stop asking. So anyway, run up here and sprint back to the guild, fast as you can. Because, well, we need to. So anyway, head down here and look at the notice board and say, oh no, we should talk to Bidoof first. So anyway, let's talk to Bidoof. And he's like, yes, are you already? So, and you've had a look around, so let's have a look. So anyway, key information here, we're switching to dual screen, because there's more information back on the notice board now. So they're talking and they're kind of looking surprised. And then it's like, what's happening? Well, we know what's happening. This is like an earthquake. And the board's flipped around because you know what happens with Doug. It's that Doug Drio. And it's, look, it's going down here. It's on the bottom screen, as you can see. I've just switched to it quickly so you can have a look. Poked it round so they can see. Because it keeps continuously updating the outlaw information. So anyway. Comes around here. And this flips round now. So anyway. I think I'll probably switch to dual screen perhaps. And Piplup is shaking. I don't know. Has it got frostbite? Probably not, because we're not near anything. But it's like, what's happening? So anyway, it's a drowsy. Could it be the one we saw earlier? Join us next time, folks. Good